You are watching Shaw Arts and Entertainment. I am your host, Curtis Anderson. We're in the Shaw TV studios today on the set of Stripped Down. Joining me today is the frontman of local band The Rebellion, Mr. Josh Palmer, no stranger to the set of Stripped Down. So many good memories between The Rebellion and Stripped Down over the years. Look back, Josh Palmer.
That's true. I can't believe it was a year ago today that we did the New Year's Eve, and then a year before that I was on the Christmas special, and then a year before that was the second time The Rebellion was on, and then 6 months before that was the very first time.
You might as well be on paycheck here at Shaw TV.
I would like that very much, actually.
Speaking of paychecks, the album The Rebellion 2 finally dropped last weekend. Sir, you transformed the Cosmo Senior Center into a rock and roll venue.
Yes.
How much work, before we talk about how awesome the night was, how much work just went into the setup?
It was a lot of work. We had a lot of volunteers, and it took about 13 hours from grabbing everything to transform the Cosmo Center from the Senior Center into a full-fledged rock venue with a professional light show, huge giant PA system, and big giant projection screens with a video crew and to capture it all. Mm-hmm. So we really put on a rock show.
And the lights.
Jay Neufeld from Shaw TV was on the lights, and Patrick was running cameras, also from Shaw.
It was a joint effort,
and it was the kind of show that we've wanted to put on for a while that was really multimedia intensive, and we're going to do it again, because that's just what we want to do, and combine that to our live show.
Okay, Curtis Anderson in the crowd, pumping his fist. The Rebellion finally takes the stage. You look out into the crowd. What was going through your head at that exact moment? All the years of work and effort. What was Josh Palmer thinking about right before he played his first note?
Just to have as much fun as possible. Like, we had worked so hard to put on the show, and it was like, that was it. It was for that hour and a half that we were playing, that was the whole reward. So when I was on stage, I was just feeling the energy flowing through me, the communication with the band, and the return with the audience, and the connection that we were making there. And just having this kind of feeling of completeness to it all, and complete happiness. I was really enjoying myself. Like, I can't wait to do another show like that again.
Thoughts, expectations on 2. We could go back and talk for another couple hours about the previous album. Like, that thing was a masterpiece. One of my favorite albums of all time. It was so good that someone got a hold of you and said, hey, you know, I'm a big shot, I want to even make it better. And there's all this online stuff going on and retooling the music, and that was quite a lengthy process. So that's all behind us. This has just been released.
That's right.
Thoughts. How excited are you? What does the future hold?
I'm very excited. This album took me a year and a half from start to completion. Like, I produced it myself, mixed, mastered, recorded it, everything. So it was a completely independent effort with the band, of course. It's self-released as well. We're pretty much doing everything ourselves. So we're actually already, because this was the Saskatoon release, but the album has been out for a few months since the summer. So we toured it to Montreal. We toured it down to Los Angeles and showcased there for the people West Coast. It's been nominated for Rock Song of the Year at the Hollywood Music and Media Awards. And unfortunately, we didn't win, but it was an amazing
event.
Nice to be nominated.
That's one of those rare times where I think you actually mean that statement.
Yeah, it was really great to be nominated. And so we're already looking, we're stepping into the studio in December and January and starting to do 3. The Rebellion 3, and this is just a continuation on the path, and we know that it is a growth effort. We feel really proud about this record, and I hope you guys feel the same. You can check it out, therebellion.ca, download it right from the website, and.
Speaking of winning awards, and the Stripped Down Awards, Dr. Don't was up for Best Song of the Past 5 Seasons, as well as the acoustic version of Spell, which you can't get. However, you can get the full band version of Spell, which is arguably my favorite Rebellion song right there. That is worth the price right there, just that one track. It's like the rest of the tracks are free, just buy it for Spell. The rest is good, but man, that's a 5-star song.
Right on. Well, thank you so much, man. I really appreciate all the support over the years, and you guys have been awesome to us, so thank you so much, Shaw. Thank you so much, Curtis. It's been great, man.
The support's been mutual. This guy won the Lifetime Achievement Award for helping out Stripped Down. much deserved. I mean, every time we're in a bind here on Stripped Down, it's Josh Parham that comes to the rescue. And that being said, big plans in the work for Rebellion Return on Stripped Down. Look for that in 2012. Don't want to let the cat out of the bag, but you haven't been on actual Stripped Down for the last season, so it's going to be big, the big return of the Rebellion on Stripped Down. Stay tuned. Thank you.
Right on. Thank you. Cheers.
Josh Palmer, Spell.